one of the things he carried for us, of course, first and foremost, he carried our sins. Praise the Lord. But the Bible also says he carried our diseases. Amen. Himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. With his stripes, we are healed. But he also carried our poverty.
One of the essential biblical problems with the prosperity gospel is an over-realized eschatology, meaning the things that are promised gloriously for us. We're all going to be rich. We're going to own the world. We're going to judge angels. Paul used that argument in 1 Corinthians 3. Don't you realize that you are going to inherit the world? The world is yours. Paulus is yours. Cephas is yours. Life is yours. Death is yours. And the conclusion he drew was, why would you boast in men? In other words, why wouldn't you take that as a means of enabling you to suffer and be lowly and kind and servant-like and walk on this Calvary road and take the pain of being a Christian? That's coming. But what they do, instead of say, we have to wait for that and pour our lives out through many tribulations here, they say, bring it now. Bring it now. The kingdom's already here, right? Jesus brought the kingdom. And it's the overlap of these two ages they don't understand. The new age is a beautiful age, and there are healings that happen in this world. I don't deny that. I just deny very vehemently everybody's going to be healed.